This is a summary of the CPIC dosing guideline for atomoxetine and variation in the gene CYP2D6. This guideline was published in February 2019. Patients with lower CYP2D6 activity scores may show increased atomoxetine-induced side effects. However, they may also show an improved clinical response and be at a decreased risk of discontinuing atomoxetine therapy compared to patients with a higher CYP2D6 activity score. To assist with atomoxetine dosing, this guideline provides information about plasma drug concentration testing as a way to assess atomoxetine exposure. This information should be used in cases where the patient initially fails to respond to atomoxetine. This guideline also provides specific recommendations for the use of atomoxetine in children and adults. If a patient is a CYP2D6 ultrarapid metabolizer or a normal metabolizer who does not carry the STAR10 allele, they should be given a dose increase after 3 days of treatment. If they do not respond to atomoxetine therapy after 2 weeks of treatment, assessing the peak plasma concentration 1 to 2 hours after administration should be considered. Dose increase is not required for patients who are CYP2D6 intermediate metabolizers, poor metabolizers, or normal metabolizers who carry the STAR10 allele. If these patients do not respond to atomoxetine therapy after 2 weeks of treatment, assessing the peak plasma concentration 2 to 4 hours after administration should be considered. This image is adapted from the PharmGKB atomoxetine pathway. A link to the original pathway is provided in the description below this video. Atomoxetine is a selective norepinephrine reuptake inhibitor, which is approved for the treatment of attention deficit hyperactivity disorder, or ADHD. It is metabolized in the liver to form a number of metabolites. Central to this guideline is the metabolism of atomoxetine by CYP2D6 to the metabolite 4-hydroxyatomoxetine. Although 4-hydroxyatomoxetine is an active metabolite, it is only found at very low concentrations in the body and is rapidly inactivated by glucuronidation. Therefore, it is not considered to exert a substantial clinical effect. In patients with higher CYP2D6 activity scores, the metabolism of atomoxetine is increased. This puts the patient at an increased risk of not responding to atomoxetine therapy and at an increased risk of discontinuing atomoxetine therapy. In patients with lower CYP2D6 activity scores, atomoxetine metabolism is reduced. As a result, these patients may experience more side effects, but also an improved clinical response to atomoxetine. There are over 100 different CYP2D6 alleles, which are designated as STAR alleles. Each STAR allele can be assigned an activity value based on its activity level compared to the STAR1 allele. The STAR1 allele has an activity value of 1. This table gives the activity values of some CYP2D6 STAR alleles, taken from the CYP2D6 allele functionality table found on the PharmGKB website. A link to the CYP2D6 allele functionality table is given in the description below this video. The STAR10 allele has been assigned an activity score of 0.5 in previous CPIC guidelines. However, it has been observed that the STAR10 allele shows a greater reduction in activity compared to other decreased function alleles. As such, this guideline provides specific recommendations based on the presence or absence of the STAR10 allele. Further clarification of the activity score assigned to the STAR10 allele will come at the end of the CPIC CYP2D6 genotype to phenotype standardization project. A link to information about the project is given in the description below this video. Be aware that some CYP2D6 alleles have an unknown functional status and should be interpreted with caution on a genetic test. In addition, an important caveat for all genotyping tests is that any alleles which are not detected in the assay are designated as STAR1. This can include rare increased function, reduced function, and non-functional alleles which are not routinely screened for in some genotyping tests. It is also important to note that patients can carry multiple copies of CYP2D6. Reports in the scientific literature have described cases where up to 13 copies of CYP2D6 were present in a patient's genome. Alleles which are present in multiple copies are given the suffix XN, where N is the number of copies of that allele that are present in a genome. For example, a patient with the genotype STAR2X3STAR4 has 3 copies of the STAR2 allele and 1 copy of the STAR4 allele. The activity score of alleles that are present in multiple copies is calculated by multiplying the activity score for the allele by the number of copies present. In this case, the activity score of STAR2X3 is 1 multiplied by 3, which equals 3. Further information about CYP2D6 alleles can be found at the PharmVar website at www.pharmvar.org. A link to PharmVar is also given in the description below this video. The activity values of a patient's CYP2D6 alleles can be added together to give a total CYP2D6 activity score for the patient. The CYP2D6 activity score is then used to assign a CYP2D6 metabolizer phenotype to the patient. Note that genetic tests from different laboratories may not use this scheme to assign CYP2D6 metabolizer phenotypes. Because of this, the guideline advises that a patient's CYP2D6 diplotype is noted and activity score calculated before making clinical decisions based on this guideline. A prominent example of this is the assignment of diplotypes with an activity score of 1, which have been assigned a normal metabolizer status by CPIC. Data from the scientific literature suggests that these diplotypes have a reduced activity towards some drugs, including atomoxetine, compared to diplotypes with an activity score of 1.5 or 2. Indeed, some reference laboratories classify diplotypes with an activity score of 1 as intermediate metabolizers. This current controversy is reflected in the guideline, where diplotypes with an activity score of 1 are noted to be normal or intermediate metabolizers. These are the CPIC dosing recommendations for atomoxetine in children. Patients with a CYP2D6 ultra-rapid metabolizer phenotype are unlikely to reach adequate serum concentrations of atomoxetine using standard dosing. However, this observation is based on limited data. These patients should begin atomoxetine therapy at a dose of 0.5 mg per kilogram per day, increasing to 1.2 mg per kilogram per day after 3 days. If there are no side effects or clinical response after 2 weeks of treatment, obtaining a peak plasma concentration 1 to 2 hours after administration should be considered. If the peak plasma concentration is less than 200 nanograms per milliliter, a dose increase should be considered. This is a moderate recommendation. Patients with a CYP2D6 activity score between 1.5 and 2 are less likely to respond to atomoxetine and are therefore at a higher risk of discontinuing atomoxetine therapy. These patients should begin atomoxetine therapy at a dose of 0.5 mg per kilogram per day, increasing to 1.2 mg per kilogram per day after 3 days. If there are no side effects or clinical response after 2 weeks of treatment, obtaining a peak plasma concentration 1 to 2 hours after administration should be considered. If the peak plasma concentration is less than 200 nanograms per milliliter, a dose increase should be considered. This is a moderate recommendation. Patients with a CYP2D6 activity score of 1 and who do not carry the STAR10 allele may have increased plasma concentrations of atomoxetine compared to patients with a higher CYP2D6 activity score, although the clinical significance of this is questionable. These patients may also be at an increased risk of discontinuing atomoxetine therapy compared to CYP2D6 poor metabolizers. These patients should begin atomoxetine therapy at a dose of 0.5 mg per kilogram per day, increasing to 1.2 mg per kilogram per day after 3 days. If there are no side effects or clinical response after 2 weeks of treatment, obtaining a peak plasma concentration 1 to 2 hours after administration should be considered. If the peak plasma concentration is less than 200 nanograms per milliliter, a dose increase should be considered. This is a moderate recommendation. patients with a CYP2D6 activity score of 1 and who carry the STAR10 allele may have increased plasma concentrations of atomoxetine compared to patients with a higher CYP2D6 activity score. These patients may also be at an increased risk of discontinuing atomoxetine therapy compared to CYP2D6 poor metabolizers. These patients should begin atomoxetine therapy at a dose of 0.5 mg per kilogram per day. If there are no side effects or clinical response after 2 weeks of treatment, obtaining a peak plasma concentration 2 to 4 hours after administration should be considered. If the peak plasma concentration is less than 200 nanograms per milliliter, a dose increase should be considered. A dose reduction should be considered if the patient develops unacceptable side effects. This is a moderate recommendation. Patients with a CYP2D6 intermediate metabolizer phenotype will have decreased metabolism of atomoxetine compared to normal metabolizers, but still may be at an increased risk of discontinuing atomoxetine therapy compared to poor metabolizers. These patients should begin atomoxetine therapy at a dose of 0.5 mg per kilogram per day. If there are no side effects or clinical response after 2 weeks of treatment, obtaining a peak plasma concentration 2 to 4 hours after administration should be considered. If the peak plasma concentration is less than 200 nanograms per milliliter, a dose increase should be considered. A dose reduction should be considered if the patient develops unacceptable side effects. This is a moderate recommendation. Patients with a CYP2D6 poor metabolizer phenotype will have significantly decreased metabolism of atomoxetine. This may lead to an increase in side effects, but can also lead to a greater improvement in ADHD symptoms compared to other metabolizer phenotypes. These patients should begin atomoxetine therapy at a dose of 0.5 mg per kilogram per day. If there are no side effects or clinical response after 2 weeks of treatment, obtaining a peak plasma concentration 2 to 4 hours after administration should be considered. If the peak plasma concentration is less than 200 nanograms per milliliter, a dose increase should be considered. A dose reduction should be considered if the patient develops unacceptable side effects. This is a strong recommendation. The dosing recommendations for atomoxetine in children can be found in Table 2 of the guideline. Detailed footnotes pertaining to the recommendations can be found at the bottom of this table. These are the CPIC dosing recommendations for atomoxetine in adults. Patients with a CYP2D6 ultra-rapid metabolizer phenotype are unlikely to reach adequate serum concentrations of atomoxetine using standard dosing. However, this observation is based on limited data. These patients should begin atomoxetine therapy at a dose of 40 mg per day, increasing to 80 mg per day after 3 days. If there are no side effects or clinical response after 2 weeks of treatment, obtaining a peak plasma concentration 1 to 2 hours after administration should be considered. If the peak plasma concentration is less than 200 nanograms per milliliter, a dose increase should be considered. This is a moderate recommendation. Patients with a CYP2D6 activity score between 1.5 and 2 are less likely to respond to atomoxetine and are therefore at a higher risk of discontinuing atomoxetine therapy. These patients should begin atomoxetine therapy at a dose of 40 mg per day, increasing to 80 mg per day after 3 days. If there are no side effects or clinical response after 2 weeks of treatment, obtaining a peak plasma concentration 1 to 2 hours after administration should be considered. If the peak plasma concentration is less than 200 nanograms per milliliter, a dose increase should be considered. This is a moderate recommendation. Patients with a CYP2D6 activity score of 1 and who do not carry the STAR10 allele may have increased plasma concentrations of atomoxetine compared to patients with a higher CYP2D6 activity score, although the clinical significance of this is questionable. These patients may also be at an increased risk of discontinuing atomoxetine therapy compared to CYP2D6 poor metabolizers. These patients should begin atomoxetine therapy at a dose of 40 mg per day, increasing to 80 mg per day after 3 days. If there are no side effects or clinical response after 2 weeks of treatment, obtaining a peak plasma concentration 1 to 2 hours after administration should be considered. If the peak plasma concentration is less than 200 nanograms per milliliter, a dose increase should be considered. This is a moderate recommendation. Patients with a CYP2D6 activity score of 1 and who carry the STAR10 allele may have increased plasma concentrations of atomoxetine compared to patients with a higher CYP2D6 activity score. These patients may also be at an increased risk of discontinuing atomoxetine therapy compared to CYP2D6 poor metabolizers. These patients should begin atomoxetine therapy at a dose of 40 mg per day. If there are no side effects or clinical response after 2 weeks of treatment, obtaining a peak plasma concentration 2 to 4 hours after administration should be considered. If the peak plasma concentration is less than 200 nanograms per milliliter, a dose increase should be considered. A dose reduction should be considered if the patient develops unacceptable side effects. This is a moderate recommendation. Patients with a CYP2D6 intermediate metabolizer phenotype will have decreased metabolism of atomoxetine compared to normal metabolizers, but still may be at an increased risk of discontinuing atomoxetine therapy compared to poor metabolizers. These patients should begin atomoxetine therapy at a dose of 40 mg per day. If there are no side effects or clinical response after 2 weeks of treatment, obtaining a peak plasma concentration 2 to 4 hours after administration should be considered. If the peak plasma concentration is less than 200 nanograms per milliliter, a dose increase should be considered. A dose reduction should be considered if the patient develops unacceptable side effects. This is a moderate recommendation. Patients with a CYP2D6 poor metabolizer phenotype will have significantly decreased metabolism of atomoxetine. This may lead to an increase in side effects, but can also lead to a greater improvement in ADHD symptoms compared to other metabolizer phenotypes. These patients should begin atomoxetine therapy at a dose of 40 mg per day. If there are no side effects or clinical response after 2 weeks of treatment, obtaining a peak plasma concentration 2 to 4 hours after administration should be considered. If the peak plasma concentration is less than 200 nanograms per milliliter, a dose increase should be considered. A dose reduction should be considered if a patient develops unacceptable side effects. This is a moderate recommendation. The dosing recommendations for atomoxetine in adults can be found in Table 3 of the guideline. Detailed footnotes pertaining to the recommendations can be found at the bottom of this table. This guideline has been annotated on the PharmGKB website. This includes a drop-down menu where an activity summary can be given for specific combinations of alleles. The activity summary includes implications for the patient's response to atomoxetine, the appropriate dosing recommendation for the specific metabolizer phenotype, and the strength of that recommendation. Remember that variation in other genes, in addition to demographic and clinical factors, including concomitant medications, can affect treatment. It remains the responsibility of the clinician to determine the best course of treatment for a patient. CPIC and PharmGKB assume no responsibility for any injury to persons or damage to persons or property arising out of or related to any use of CPIC's guideline or for any errors or omissions. The guideline itself and supplementary information are freely available at the PharmGKB and CPIC websites. You can access relevant pages using the links in the description below this video.